Hello everyone, in the series of memory management lecture, today we will discuss about segmentation. In the previous lecture, we discussed about the paging and we discussed that paging is sequence from the internal segmentation and is a system point of view phenomena. When we talk about the segmentation, segmentation is a user point of view phenomena, that means how users think about the program is loaded in that manner. Suppose we have a program. It contains a main program, procedure, some functions, some methods, some data objects. These are the sub-programs of a complete. This is a common view of a program. In this program, we have a main program, XORT function, some subroutine, stack, symbol table, and this is a memory map of logical address as well as the physical address. In the logical address, we can give the name to each program as a segment number, that means XORT function has a segment number 1, subroutine has a segment number 0 and so on, main program contains a segment number 2. Since this is a logical address space, so we have to map all the segments into a physical address. How the mapping is done? Suppose if you take the example of the main program is mapped into physical memory at the location number 4300. Where is the 4300 memory location? That is the starting address of the segment number 2. Suppose the main program contains 400 line of code, so what will be the last address of that main program? When we add the total number of instructions to the base address, we will get the last address of that segment. So in my case, main program contains the 400 line of code, so when we add the 400, we will get the last address as a 4700. In this way, all the segments are mapped into a memory. When we talk about the stack has a starting address 3200 and it has the last address 4300. In this way, all the segments are mapped into a system. When we talk about some background, all the sub-programs are stored in hard disk, and when that program wants to run, all the programs have to copy it into a RAM so that when the CPU generates the logical address, they can access the logical address into a main memory. In the segmentation, the logical address has the two tuples. First one is called the segment number and the second one is called the segment object. It is same as we learned into a paging. In the paging, the logical address contains the page number and page object. When we talk about the segmentation, in the segmentation, logical address contains segment number and the segment object. Here we use the segment table, and segment table contains two entries. First one is base address of every segment, and the second entry is the limit, that is how many instructions a segment contains. Segment table is stored into a physical memory, and the starting address of segment table is stored in a special register called the STBR, and the process control block contains the information about STBR. I want to tell you that every process has its own segment table, and the segment table is a data structure, it is not a hardware. This is a segmentation hardware in which CPU generates the logical address and we can map that logical address with the help of segment table. This is a complete diagram with the memory protection hardware. First, so CPU generates the logical address. Logical address have two tuples, segment number and segment object. With the help of segment number, we can see the limit of that segment and base address of that segment. Suppose if we generate the logical address for 2,3, and in the segment table there is a segment number 2 that the limit is 10 and the base address is 100. How this logical address map to a physical address? First of all, we take the segment number and search in the segment table. When we search the segment number 2 in the segment table, we will get the limit of that segment is 10 and the base address is 100. That means segment number 2 is mapped from 100 location. But this is the base address of that segment. That is the 100 location in the RAM. And segment number 2 is mapped from 100 location. After that, when we get the limit of that segment, we can check or compare the limit to the offset. In my case, the offset is 3 and the limit is 10. 3 is less than 10, the condition is true, that means we can access the legal offset. After that, 3 is added to a base address 100 and we will get the embed 3, and embed 3 is a physical address along with 2,3 logical address. In this way, we can map each and every logical address to a physical address. This is an example of the segmentation in which we have a logical address space, physical address space, and a segment table. How this segment table is maintained? Well, the process is actually transferred from the secondary storage to primary storage, this segment table is updated. So that when the CPU generates the logical address, we can use the segment table in order to map the logical address to physical address. We will take the example of the main program, that is the segment number 2. So with the help of the segment table, we can see that segment number 2 have the limit 400 and the base address 4300. So how to map the segment number 2? We start from 4300 location and add the limit, that is the 400, and we will get the last address, that is the 4700. So this is the entire segment number. In this way, all the segments is mapped into a segmentation. This is a numerical question related to a segmentation in which some logical addresses are there and we have to compute the physical address along with that logical address. First we take the example. Question number 1, the logical address is 0,430, and this is a segment table. With the help of that segment table, we have to compute the physical address. In the first question, we have a logical address 0,430. We take the segment 0. Segment 0 have the base address 4,219 and the length is 16. First we compare the offset to a length. Here the offset is 430 and length is 600. That means 430 is less than 600 is a valid offset. How to compute the physical address? Add the offset to a base address, you will get the physical address. In my case, base address along with segment 0 is 219. The 219 is added to a 430, you will get the physical address. In the second question, the logical address is 1,10. First we check the limit of segment number 1. Segment number 1 limit is 40. We will try to access the segment 10. This is the legal offset. So how to get the physical address? Add the offset to a base address of segment number 1. So 2,300 plus 10. That means 2,310 is the physical address along with that physical address. Similarly, when we talk about the logical address 2,500, first we check the limit of that offset. Segment number 2 have the limit or length 100 and we are trying to offset 500, so this is an illegal offset, so it is wrapped to the operating system. In next example, the logical address is 0,400. Segment number 3 contains the length 580 and we will try to access the offset 400. So 400 is less than 580, it is a legal address. How to compute the address? In the base address, we will add 400 and we will get the physical address along with this particular address. In the last question, the local address is 4,112. First we check the segment number 4 limit, that limit is 96, and we will try to compute the physical address along with 112. 112 is not less than 96, so it is an illegal address and it will pay the price. In this way, we can compute the physical address along with all the given logical address with the help of segmentation. Since segmentation supports the uneven size of partition, that means varying size partition, so that it is also suffering from the external segmentation. As we discussed in paging, paging is suffering from the internal segmentation, and segmentation is suffering from the external segmentation. So in the advanced system, we can use the combined approach of the paging and segmentation. Thank you.